Greetings and welcome back, fellow knowledge seekers. Today's video is to inform you of the underestimated, underwritten, underrated black superheroes.
Our first black superhero is Monica Rambeau, initially known as Captain Marvel, aka Pulsar, Spectrum, Daystar, Spectre, the Lady of Light, Monica Marvel, and the Sun Goddess. Her first appearance was Amazing Spider-Man, number 16, 1982. Monica was a lieutenant in the New Orleans Harbor Patrol and also operated a cargo ship as a captain. In an attempt to prevent the creation of a dangerous weapon, Monica was exposed to extra-dimensional energies. As a result, she gained the ability to convert her body to energy and back again at will. She decided to use her powers to fight crime and began calling herself Captain Marvel. She sought out the Avengers and became the first African-American female Avenger and also led the Avengers for a period of time. She has been ranked as one of the most powerful people walking around in the Marvel Universe. Her powers include energy absorption, generation, and manipulation. This energy includes, but not limited to, gamma, chemical, nuclear, gravitational, kinetic, and more. She has the ability to travel at the speed of light, convert her body into any form of energy within the electromagnetic spectrum, and travel in energy form through the vacuum of space. She is very durable and possesses superhuman strength that rivals Silver Surfer and Thor. She has battled the Olympian gods, the immortal Dracula, Super Adaptoid, Nebula, the superpowered Beyonder, and a confused Jean Grey of the Phoenix Force, Kang the Conqueror, and Atuma, and also battled and won against the all-powerful Grandmaster. She has done this alongside of Earth's mightiest heroes such as Spider-Man, Captain America, Doctor Strange, She-Hulk, Scarlet Witch, Hyperion, Black Bolt, and many, many more.
Icon. First appearance in Icon, issue number 1, May 1993. In 1839, an alien starliner malfunctioned and exploded, jettisoning a life pod in the middle of a cotton field in the American South. The pod automatically altered the appearance of its passenger, named Arnis, to mimic the first sentient life form who had discovered. The life form was an enslaved black woman named Miriam, who saw the pod crash land and adopted Arnis as her son. In the present, Arnis is still alive. He did not age visibly beyond adulthood. To disguise this fact, he periodically assumes the identity of his own son. By the late 20th century, he's posing as Augustus Freeman IV, the grandson of his original human identity. Still marooned, Arnis / Freeman waits for the Earth's technology to catch up to his life pods. Secretly posing superpowers that belay his human appearance, he has always performed quiet acts of charity. However, when Freeman's house is broken into, he uses his powers for the first time in decades as an action witnessed by one of the intruders, Raquel Irvin, an idealistic teenager who was born in Paris Island, the poorest, most gang-ridden neighborhood in Dakota City. Her prospects seem fairly bleak until the encounter with Freeman. After seeing Freeman use his powers, Raquel persuades him to become the superhero named Icon, with herself as his sidekick, Rocket.